Hello everyone. In today's class, we are going to learn about estimating products. So look at the example here. Estimate the product of 28 and 25. So here we have the numbers 28 and 25. So here what you have to do means this one you have to round off to nearest 10. So 28. So when you round off to nearest 10, we will get 30. So how we will round off nearest 10 means, so here you have to check this number in ones place. So in ones place we have 8. So if you have greater than 5, so this number will change to next number. So this 28 will become into 30. Next, we have 25. So this 25, when you round off to 30, when you round off to 10, what you will get is 30. So here in ones place you have 5, so it will change into next 10. So that means 30. So when you multiply this after rounding off to the tens, what we got here, 30 into 30, these two if you multiply, we will get 900 answer. But let us see actually what we, if you multiply this both number as it is, how much we will get. 28 into 25, when we multiply, we will get 700. But here 900 we got. So for this 900 and 700, there is a lot of variance. So it should be like closely. So in this case, what you have to do? You find that there is a considerable difference between the answers. Let us try another technique. Let us round up one number up and the other down. So that means one number you have to round up, the another number you should round off to that down. So this 28, when you round off to nearest 10, you will get 30. Then this 25, when you round off 10, that means when you round off down, so we will get 20. So next 30 into 20. So when you multiply here, so 23 is a 60 and the 0 you will get. So when you multiply 30 into 20, we will get 600. At least this 600, it is near to this. So we can use this method for estimating. So next, let us see one more example. Estimate the products of 275 and 135. So rounding the nearest 100 we have. So 275, when you round off to 300, 275, when you round up, we will get 300. So 135, when you round off down, rounded down, so we will get 100. So when you multiply 300 into 100, so we will get 30,000. So the answer, you will get 30,000. The actual product, when you multiply 275 into 135, you will get 37,125. At least this is near to this number. Next, you see, by rounding off the nearest 10. So here in exercise, we have the sums like 76 into 18. So the 76, when you round up to nearest 10, so we will get 80. Then this 18 also, when you round off to nearest 10, we will get 20. So then now this you have to multiply 80 into 20. So 80 into 20, when you multiply, you will get 1600 as answer. Next, you see, by rounding off to the nearest 100. So here the sum is 643 into 549. The 643, when you round off to nearest 100, we will get 600. So when you round off to nearest 100, you have to check the place in the tens column. So here in the tens column, if you have less than 5, so the number will not turn to next 100. And if it is in case, if it is greater than 5 means, the number will turn to next number. So here in tens place, we have 4, so which is less than 5. So this number will not round off to 100. So that we can write 600. Next also say 549, same thing here also in tens place, you have 4, which is less than 5. So this number, when you round off to nearest 100, you will get 500. So now after rounding off, we got here 600 into 500. So this, when you multiply 600 into 500, so what we will get here? 3 lakhs we will get as a answer. Next, you see, rounding up and down to nearest 10. So here example 85 into 42 you have. So 85, when you round up, so that means round off to tens, you will get 90. Then this 42, when you round up here, you will get 40. So when you round off to nearest to tens here, you have to check in ones place. So in ones place 5 is there, so it will next change to next 10. Here 42, so which is less than 5, in ones place you have 2, so which is less than 5. So this number will turn to 40. So now this 90 into 40, you have to multiply. So when you multiply 90 into 40, you will get as 3600 is the answer. Next, you see, rounding up and down to nearest 100, 463 into 151. So this 463, when you round up, so 406, in here, when you Round off to nearest 100 means you have to check in tens place. So here in the tens place you have 6, which is greater than 5. So this number will change to next 100. So that is 500. So next 151, when you round up down, so this you will get as 100. So when you multiply 500 into 100, so you will get 50,000 as a answer. So in this way, we will round up to the nearest. So that means estimating. So by estimating in this way, we will round up. Okay, I hope you all understood. Thank you.